बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। दिस इज जिशान बुखारी, सीनियर इंग्लिश टीचर, लोअर सेकेंडरी सेक्शन, एसएमपी कायदाबाद पब्लिक स्कूल। अगेन आई वेलकम यू ऑल फॉर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस बीइंग कंडक्टेड बाय एसएमपी कैट्स। टुडे वी आर हियर द लेक्चर डिलीवर्ड बाय मी ऑफ क्लास 7 English. Class 7 English. You can see here Class 7 English. And our topic is the main topic of grammar, part of speech. Topic is adjective. Before proceeding further, I am going to tell you some short definition of the adjective. Then I will tell you the degrees of adjective. You can see here degrees of adjective, how to explain it. I am going to tell you after this definition. Now open your copies and write it in your fair copy. We have adjective. This is our part of speech, and here is some short definition of adjective. It tells us that definition is, it is a word which shows quality of noun and pronoun. It means it describes us either he or she, tall, big, sweet, and the talking is sweet. It means it gives us the description of thing, of a person, anything else. It gives some description about that. You can see here our example that he is a tall. He is tall. It means it tells us that the person which is in front of me, it tells about him that he is the tall man. And secondly, she is clever. In other words, I should say she is naughty, and I should say she is in sad mood. Number third is, my father is an old man. Old is you can see here, old is there. It gives us some description that old or young. Right? My father is an old man. Now, this is our definition, this example. Come to the main topic of today's lecture, is degrees of adjective. There are 3 degrees of adjective: positive degree, comparative degree, and number 3rd is superlative degree. Now, in this lecture, I will tell you all the definitions of these degrees of adjective. But first, here I have written positive degree. Here is the comparison between positive degree, comparative degree, and also superlative degree. But first, we have to understand that what is the positive degree of an adjective. This positive degree shows the actual word is adjective. It means this degree will always comes in the adjective. Comparison between positive, comparative, and superlative. Now, number 1 is positive degree. The positive degree. What is the positive degree of an adjective? Number 1 is, there is some short definition, then you can understand what it tells us. Now, the definition is positive degree. It is a simple form of adjective. Simple form. It shows quality of kind, thing or a person. Quality. As I have already told you, is an adjective that it is some description about that person, that the person who is standing in front of you, either he is tall or big, either he is fair or darkish. These are the descriptions of the adjective of noun and pronoun. Here is what it is, that the positive degree, it is a simple form of adjective. It shows quality of time, thing or person, and is used when no comparison is needed. Positive degree is used when there is no any comparison between comparative and superlative. No any comparison. You can see here, no any comparison is needed. Right? Now we have some example. You can see here, he is an intelligent. No any comparison. He just tells us that he is an intelligent person. Means Muiz is an intelligent person. Abdul Wahab is an intelligent person. Bilal is an intelligent person. You can take any names. He tells us that Abdul Karim is an intelligent boy. Intelligent means it is a positive degree of adjective. Now we have number second. This is a beautiful house. In other words, I should say that our class is a beautiful room. Our class will become a beautiful room because of you. If you decorate this, our class, then everybody looks in our class and anyone says that our class is a beautiful house. But here I write a sentence that this is a beautiful house. Now he is a rich person. Rehan is a rich person. Amargul is a rich person. He is telling you a description about a person that he either is poor by financially or he is a rich. He can afford anything by the study expenses or any visiting expenses. We have completed the definitions of adjective and we have also started the degrees of adjective. And I have already told you the positive degree. Here is number second is comparative degree. Comparative. Definition is, it shows the higher degree of quality, higher degree than positive. It is used when two things of same kind are compared. In this sense, we have some comparison between two people, between two things. Here I have written some example. You can see here, Tariq is stronger than Khan. In other words, I should say that Kashif is stronger than Umair. Got it? Number second is, this house is more beautiful than yours. This school, my school, is more beautiful than your school. Number third, Hira is more wiser than Ifar. I should say that Shaheen is more wiser than Nainama. Now we have completed comparative degree. In this comparative, we have discussed, we have comparison between two things. Now number third degree of adjective, which is superlative degree, and that is, it shows the highest degree, highest. In comparative, higher degree,
is the highest degree of adjective. It is used when more than two words
in superlative degree and comparative degree feel the difference that in comparative degree there is higher. In superlative there is highest, mean the populist. Intelligence from all the codes. Now it shows the highest degrees of adjective. It is used when more than two. In this comparative, it is used when two things, just two things. But in superlative sense, in superlative case, we have told that it is used when more than two things of same type are compared as, which means we have to compare more than two words, more than two things, more than two persons. Example, Kamra is the best boy in the class. In other words, I should say Usman is the best student in the class. Got it? Now, number second point is, this house is most beautiful of all. My school is most beautiful than all schools. Number third, the Pacific Ocean is the deepest of all the oceans. This is comparison more than two. Now, the Pacific Ocean is the deepest of all the oceans. We have completed our today's topic. I hope that you have understood it, and please note down that copy these definitions in your fair book. I will check you when the school will be opened. But in our next lecture, I will tell you how the adjective is compared between comparative degree and superlative degree. For today, we will meet you inshallah in our next lecture.